It's your boy Dilly D. We are doing another American Truck Simulator. As I've mentioned in our last video, I'm trying to make at least 100,000 before I even think about buying my own truck and starting my doing really my own thing. As you can see right now, we have $96,539. So we need to make one more trip, and this trip is gonna send us way over 100,000, which is good. We're trying to make some money, and of course we're gonna be going to the bank, and let's see. And we are eligible for the 400,000 loan, so we're gonna be getting that, and hopefully by the end of the video we'll be on our next video we'll be buying a new truck, you know, trying to pimp it out and stuff like that, and possibly try to get or hire another driver as well. So without any further ado, let's go to the job market here. Let's see what we can get. We have another oversized load here. This one weighs 118,500 pounds. We need to make a little bit of money out of this one. This one goes to Busto. We already been there. I don't know which one I should take. This one is only 13,000. It goes to Camp Vade in Arizona. And this one, no, this one stays in California and stuff. And then we have another one here for 13 grand. This one goes to Auckland. What's the mileage in this one? 364 miles to go, and this one is 381, but it pays less, so I don't know how that is. And it goes to Nevada, but I think we should just get this one and try, and let's just take this job. 15 grand, it's not bad, it's not bad at all. As you can see right now, we are in the truck. Let's just go outside here and see what our load looks like. I think it's the similar load that we took last time, but I think for our next loads we need to kind of do a variety of loads and stuff like that, just to make sure that we don't do the same thing over and over. I think we're going to be starting doing that after we buy our own truck. Right now we're just trying to make some money, and we are in this Kenworth, I think it's the T680 if I'm not mistaken. So yeah, we're going to be taking this load. So without any further delay, let's just get right to it. Get to the cab here, let's set up this bad boy. I mean, it doesn't sound bad at all, so let's try and get another mirror right there. Now let's... I think I need to download the New Mexico and stuff, and see how that one goes. Let's get to it. There's no car coming here. Light as well. We don't want to get any tickets or do anything stupid, so yeah, trying to do this correctly, if I should say so myself. Let's see here, can you get it? Nah. Just go in here. Get ready. Okay. cars or police cars. I think I've seen like a whole range of different models. I think it looks really, really good. Oh, our speed here is 30. And of course, you're not gonna make this red light. We don't wanna get any tickets here. Let's get it all the way to one. I think for truck to buy, we have an option to buy a Volvo. I'm not really sure. Not really sure if I like the Volvo. But we do have an option to buy it. I think something to look into. We're gonna be comparing trucks and see which one fits us best. But I think the other version of the Kenworth is much, much better than the Volvo. But I'm just saying, I don't know the difference. Massive, massive weight here. And I do have mods in this on my profile. Not that many. I think I just have the one that unlocks everything in terms of trucks, to put it on level 0 and stuff like that. But I'm already at level 6. So that doesn't really make that much of a difference, but I think it does in some version. Whoa, 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 whoa. I wasn't even paying attention to the speed limit there. I found myself going 65 on a 55. A ticket was about to come my way very, very quickly there. Could have failed the mission right there. My mission is to not get any tickets or any citations for that matter until the end of my journey, so that I can get the maximum value and money that I can get for this trip. That will really, really go a long way in terms of modifying our truck and stuff. This one is an 18 speed. Now let's see where our journey, we haven't had any damages yet, but I'm sure by the end of the trip it's gonna be like 1% for the truck, but that's not a big deal. As you can see, our car, we are expected to be at our destination on Thursday at 4:19 p.m. between that time and 10:59 p.m. so I think we're gonna make good time, but it's already Thursday, 9:53 right now, so we have really a couple hours to go. Next rest stop in 12 hours. I think we need to change lanes here. Ooh! Whoa, 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 whoa. Pay attention to the road, that's what they say. I think I smashed that police car right there. Not good. Not good. We already failed our mission here. Let's see how much damage. 4% for the truck and 5% for our cargo. That's really, really bad. That's really, really bad. Oh well, I think we need to fix our truck. We'll do what we can. I haven't went to a garage and fixed anything yet, so I think it'll be like learning process as well, but really, really disappointed with that. Right now we have 283 miles to go. We might make it on time, we might not. I have no idea at this point. Look at us speeding again. We're going 60 at 55. I think that's really, really bad. We need to go on cruise control here. Just keep it at 80 or 58. I've been driving at 58 for most of the time. I think it's much, much better than going right at the speed limit. We need to try our best and get there in time, really. We do have time. We do have a lot of time to accomplish this journey and be there in a reasonable amount of time. Get outside here. Let's see this beast. Why is it wobbling like that? It is wobbling. Boy. We need to find a place where we can refuel here. I don't think we can make it. We cannot go 227 miles with the fuel that we have on board right now. And the truck is a little bit banged up as well. So if we can get both, something of both worlds, I think it will suit us even better. I think we can skip that rest stop right there and see if we can get something much, much better and close to the road. But I'm sure it's gonna be miles away from here. So we kind of need to play it safe now. Now that we are already past that rest station right there, so hopefully we don't run out. Hopefully you don't have to call for service and stuff. We don't have to press F7 in this journey, because that will cost us money. We already lost money for damaging the trailer. We already lost money. I mean the truck owner is gonna be paying for this. I hope it's not gonna come out of our pockets, but I think it's going to come out of our pockets. Hopefully it's not more than 1,000. Listen to me being very, very greedy. There is another one. Another scenario here. Oh, come on, bro. That truck broke down or something? Did I just see a ST Hummer right there? Wait to buy my own truck. Can't wait to modify it and stuff. If you guys can comment down below, let me know what truck would you guys want me to buy. But I think it won't matter really. By the time that I upload that video, I'll have done the truck a long time ago. So. But for future reference, you guys can just let me know, and then I'll get the truck you guys want. This cargo is really wide. I think it's because of the wheels as well. It just touches one line to the other. And for those wondering, I'm using a keyboard. That's why you see the steering wheel, it just rubbles around because I'm using a keyboard. Yeah. I've had this problem before. I downloaded like a lot of mods on the Steam community, and then or Steam Workshop, I mean. And then when I put those mods in the game, they crashed the game. I heard somebody mention something about how you have to arrange the mods in a proper way. It's a simple thing to say, arrange the mods in a simple, in a proper way. But how do you know which mod? How do you know the sequence of the mod, like the arrangement of the mods that you need to do to make sure like they are put in a proper way? Oops, we need to turn here, and hopefully this part we can get that gas station that we're craving for. Whoa. There you go. Just when I thought there's nothing there. Thank you. keep passing gas stations. I think I'm gonna regret this. I think I'm gonna regret passing these gas stations, that's for sure. I feel like going back and go refuel in this one. That's what I feel like. On that side over there, there seems to be a question mark. I feel like going to go investigate. Maybe it is another trunking company or something of that nature. I'm gonna go investigate this. I'm gonna go investigate this. I'm gonna go investigate this one. Let's see what we can discover here. Where are we now? In Bakersfield. Okay. This load is just too heavy. Make sure we don't hit anything here. Can we fix our truck here? Repairs. It costs 1,058 cents. Repairs are covered by employer. Okay, let's get that sorted out. With does it fix, can you do upgrades here? No. Well, this is not our truck, so I don't know what would be upgrading this thing. Let's see if you can get something like the accessories. Nothing there. Where is the beacon department? Can you get a beacon? What has this changed? Chassis and all? I don't think we need to do all this. Let me see if I can find the beacon. That's not necessary. You can pimp it out like that, but that's not necessary. We don't really need to do this. So let's just leave. I think we have done our good deed here. Yeah. up a massive. Anyways. Now let's get on with our journey. You only fixed the truck, not our trailer. We got a sunroof here as well. That's nice. We got that sunroof. I think it's our turn to go here. We have 2 hours and 42 minutes to go. So that will put us at 4 p.m. At the beginning of our in-between time to deliver this thing. So I think we are on good, on a good track. I mean, to get to our destination on time. Not that that matters in any shape or form, but. I need to change lane here real quick and call back to the center. ...116 miles to go. We'll be there in time, that's for sure. So that's a good plus. And then after that, we're gonna be buying a new truck, and hopefully everything goes very, very well, so we don't get to. I think that in the next video will all be about buying the new truck and you know, putting some new shit on it, stuff like that. Come on. Come on. I know it's heavy. Seeing that police car makes me wanna go play GTA 5. LSPDFR right now. Whoa. And the police car is so close, and we're going like 70 miles per hour. I can't seem to get the concept of this thing. I mean, to just to be legal on the road is like it's proving to be a little bit difficult. I don't know why. I'm not paying much attention to my speed. I'm not paying much attention to what's going on around me. I think I need to start playing this game properly. that said, we have 65 miles to go, and we have 1 hour and 23 minutes to do so. So I think that puts us in really, really good time. 10:19 p.m. is way far that we're gonna deliver this. We're gonna be delivering this this cargo. Look, check out this Camaro right there. That shit looks nice. That's a cop right. Whoa, 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 whoa. And the other thing, we still haven't got any gas yet. I think we're gonna be running on fumes very, very soon if we don't get a filling station here. I think this trip is turning out to be more of a disaster than I planned. But yeah, kind of disappointing. I didn't expect this from this trip. We're still at 4, now we are dropping down to 40 miles per hour. And then it's gonna drop down to 35, and then here it's gonna pick up again to 55. That's a whole lot of speed dropping in a very short space of time, so I don't think that's any way realistic in any shape or form, but that's what we have to work with. Miles to go. Can we make it without refueling? I have no idea. No idea. I think this steep climb is a little bit. I'm just gonna drink whatever we have in the tank dry. Just gonna suck it dry. Very, very fast. Well, at least there's no car coming there. Eh? 15 miles to go. The end is in sight. I can smell it. Come on. Only 15 to go. We are running out of fuel. We should find a gas station very soon. That's what I'm thinking. Look at that. We're gonna run out of fuel. I think we are turning here. I'll get any gas station that I can find right now. And the end is right there, so can we make it? I'll just choose the easiest parking there is here so that. Oh, I already know what it is, so. I think I've been here before. What? Alright. I think it's just a drive. Drive in. Let's get out here. What would happen if you just ran out of fuel, like, right here? Oh, that would just... I mean, not perfect, but I cannot complain about this. Check it down there, right there. Yeah. Something like that. Let's just drop it. Reasonable. That was just a failure. Damage penalty 3,337, and when we lost 204 XP, that's just horrible. That is just horrible. Out of that 15,000, we only got paid 12,333. I think that should be my last mess up that I do in this game. But with that said, we're just gonna add our XP right there. As you can see right now, we have 108,251. So I was hoping for something more than that, at least 111 or some sort, but that did not happen. We lost 3,000 in this one. So hopefully in our next video is gonna be something much better. But thank you so much for watching. Please do subscribe to the channel if you like it, and please don't forget to drop a like on the video. Yeah, and I'll see you guys in the next one. I'm out.